Hi friends, welcome to Srinu Technologies. Myself Ram Kumar. We will discuss more about case management, also called queue management, in Blue Prism. Right? In my previous video, we have seen how to configure a queue and then how to add items to a queue. We have seen that only, right? So we will go further and see how we can retrieve each item in queue and then do some process logic, and then we can mark the status as accordingly, right? So let's jump to the tool and then see, we can see how it is. Control room queue management place, and then we have seen that there are some six records which are already there, right? We will try to process these records and then we'll go further. Okay, so I went to a place where this queue is there. So to process it, I will not use the same thing, because if I use a sub page or sub process, main page will be the starting for it, right? So it will be a problem for us. So let me create an object quickly. Under objects, it's a new thing, and then what we say, queue object or something. Okay, this is what I'm saying. Next, sample queue management object. Okay, finish, and then we have this object. Let me open. We have loaded the data from process, and the process we have called one object which is already implicitly available in the Blue Prism, which is called work queue, and then we have done it. Now we are creating a new object to process the queue data. This is our own specific thing. Adding data to queue is implicit to Blue Prism tool. It's in already feature is available, but how we want to retrieve and how you want to use or how you want to process the data is up to you, right? So we have to create it. So let me write a process called queue data. Okay, queue data. Queue data is fine. Queue data calculation, something like this. I've kept the name as something. And then what we have to do now? So first we need to, we will not be getting, we have imported the queue, or we have imported the items which are in the form of collection into a queue. So we cannot retrieve all the items at one shot. We can retrieve one by one, means record by record, right? So we will take an action, and then which is, I will say get item. Okay, and then I think you know what is the work queues. Work queues is the object which is implicitly available in the Blue Prism, and then it is used for managing the queues. So if you see here, add to queue, but we don't want to add to queue, we want to read items from queue. So what is there is get, so there are two things here: get item data, get next item. So when you have the item ID, you can pass the item ID. So if I select this, if you see here, get item data, it is taking the input as item ID, and then the output will be the item details, right? Along with the collection, the record which is having multiple columns is also a collection, and then the collection will be returned to us with only one record inside it. All the other details, like we have in the queue, we have seen, right? What is the priority, status, what is the tag, what is the load time, so what is the exception time. So those all details will be coming here, which we don't want. So this can be used when we have the item ID in place or item details handy. So we don't have it, we want to go with get next item. If you see here, get next item is nothing but, if I go to the inputs, it is asking for on which queue we want to get the get next item. So I want to get it from, so the name should be exactly same. So better use copy paste, otherwise we'll be in trouble if there is a match. So tag filter, think that there are thousands of, so this is the important here. So tags can be for reporting purpose and also for filtering purpose. Think that I have loaded November data, December data, and then I have loaded October data, many data, but I am focused on processing the November data first, for example. So then you can give the filter ID, filter tag name here within double quotes, and then that data will be retrieved. Okay, only that it will be retrieved. For now, we are not giving anything. So these things we will see in the next use case. For now, we will see the basic stuff. So when I give the just the queue name, it will retrieve the queue items one by one. Okay, just understand that perspective. Outputs. What is the output? So what is the status? Means whether it is successful or not. So we don't need it actually. And then what is the item ID and what is the collection? Item ID is nothing but when, as I said, when we are retrieving one by one, it will first, it will give me what is the item ID for it, means what is the encrypted ID value and what is the collection. So we want these two actually, right? So what is the item ID and what is the item data? So this is what I'm saying. So I'm creating a collection is created and a text is created. If you see here, I'm closing this. So now you have two items in your, two data variables in your place. You have it handy, right? One is the item data which is having the collection. The other one is the item ID. Once you get the item ID or the collection of data, as I told, it will have only, as of now, if you open it, it will be empty because this will come at runtime. This is not a pre-populated stuff. Okay, item ID is also empty. It's a, it will come at runtime. So now once you get the data, so student details, you remember what we have given? We have given ID, we have given name, we have given collection, and we have, sorry, location, and then we have given gender. What it is we want to process each record, and then we want to prepare, or we want to get the student name whose location is some LOC1. I think you have location 1 wise, location 2 we have given. Otherwise we will read student name for each thing. We will add some text for the given student name, and then we will add it. Example, okay, we will do this way. Gender and student we have. We want to display the student name. I want to, based on gender, I want to add Mr. or Miss. Okay, I want to add Mr. or Miss based on gender. We have a name, but we don't have Mr. or Miss in front of it, right? So I will add it based on the gender which I will be seeing, right? So let's do that. So once I have the collection, by default I want the first record. So no need to have a loop because as I am getting the first one. So let's do some decision box here, and then the decision box I will say check if male. Okay, what is the expression? In collection, item data is the collection, but that data will, so as I think we, if you remember, we have created a collection in process. I am going to the collection, and these are the student details which I loaded. One second, I need to close this thing, otherwise it will, the process will not open. So I'm just want to check what are the values is there. GNDR, gender is the variable or the column name which will retrieve me the values of this, and then ID is student name, and then this is name. So name is name. I got it. So now I'm going to the object studio once again. So check if male item data dot gender equal to, if it is male, male means yes, else it will be female. So if it is yes, what it should do, if it is yes, it should add something like Mr. If it is female, it should add something like Miss, something like this. Okay, what we'll do is we will do a calculation, and then we will take one more variable called display name. Display name is after doing the changes. Okay, data type is text and the initial value is empty. Okay, I'll make it somewhat big so that it will be easily visible for you. So calculation one is add Mr. So in the this thing, Mr. is what we want to add, space and then ampersand and then collection item data dot name. So I'm referring to the first record, and then I am referring to the column name in that particular cell. Column which is having the column name as name, In the first record, the corresponding cell value is name, and then add that value with Mr. and store it in display name. So this should not, we should forget. So this is for boy or a gent. If it is female, so it's not add Mr., it is Miss. So it is a else case, right? So we will move. So this will be Miss followed by the name. So see how I am processing the data. So this is what you might think. But there's a problem here. What the problem is, once the process is done, so we should mark the, so we have retrieved an item ID, right? So once we retrieve an item ID, we will see what is the state of that item. So first I will save this. So this is one kind of getting the data we need to. So I will keep one breakpoint, check if male, and then I will run this, and then we will see what is the data we have got, and then where it will go, and then we can judge what will be the display name, and also what is the status of the queue we will see. So before running this, I'm going to the control room. I will see, I'm refreshing the queue. If you see here, all the things are with priority, everything is fine, and then if you see here, all are with pending or initialized state. State is initial, right? Okay. So let me run the Object Studio. Here we go. So get next item, and then it stopped. If you see here, it is retrieving the complete data. So this is the item ID. Okay. And what is the collection? Collection is having, so item ID is 12345. This is the starting number if you remember, right? Name is name 1, location is location 1, gender is female. So what is the display name should be? Should be Miss name 1, right? So let us continue and see what is happening. Oh, we have not seen what is the queue details now. If I do a refresh, if you see here, the state of the first one changed from pending to logged, right? It changed from pending to logged. Logged in the sense, when an item is under processing or when the data is in processing state, it will be logged. Logged in the sense, as I was telling, right, multiple robots or multiple machines can access the same queue. So in a nanosecond or somewhat, so if you have retrieved one item data and robot 2 is trying to access item from queue, actually the logged items will not be shared. So a logged item means it is being worked upon by one machine only. Okay, so you have to map it this way. So if you are calling one more time next item, the second item will be retrieved. So what is happening is here, so we will continue this. Okay, check if male and check if not add miss, and then display, check the display name. Let me continue. So if you see here, Miss name 1, and then the process stopped. So you have to understand one thing, we have said get next item, and then we have forgot to set the status of the queue item, means whether it is the data processing is successful or not. We have not marked it anywhere. So if I go back to the queue and see, the item is, and it came to end means the processing is complete. So if you refresh this, lock moved to stage called exception. By default, if you are not marking the queue state that it is completed successfully, it will be marked as failure by default. Okay, so what we'll do is we will add one more case here, one more action here, and then say that we will say that mark status. We can mark status as success or failure based on the process. Okay, so I will say mark status success. Okay, and what is the object? Work queues. If you go here, I think set mark completed. So we need the item ID here for marking the status as complete. We need the item ID. I think you know, right? Item ID we already have. So that is the use of getting the item ID here, right? So I'm saying status, and then after this, so it is adding Mr. or Miss. There is no problem. Just mark the status as complete. So we will run this now. I will remove this breakpoint. Okay, otherwise I will keep the breakpoint and see how the status is going on, and then let's see this. Okay, let's refresh the queue once and see whether it is everything is fine. Yes, and then you can see, right, there are still 5 items. Okay, so once marked as success or exception or anything, it cannot be reused. You have to load the queue again and then use it. So if it is getting the item and then it is like this, breakpoint came, if you go back to the control room, refresh it, the second item, the item which is logged will be on the top. Okay, if you see here, exception which you have seen earlier, automatically set exception at cleanup, means the system has given the status exception. If you go to the last also, you will see that there is some exception occurred, means that the either the user have forgot to mark the status or there is some problem with the process. This is what we need to understand. Okay, so let us see how this will go now. Over. So let me refresh and then go back to the control room and refresh it. If you see here, the latest process, the latest one which is done, the processing is done, right? After 4-5, 4-6 is the item key which happened, and then if you see here, it is successful. There is no error. If you go to the right, the completed timestamp is there, but the exception timestamp is not there. Okay, the total time it took is 35 seconds, because we paused it for some time. The earlier one we took 1 minute 44 seconds. So this is what it is there. If you go to the top, if you see the report, student queue, one item worked, means completed is 1, pending is 4, exception is 1, so total are 6, and this is the average time. Okay, you might have one doubt actually, for every item I have to trigger like this, or if there are 1000, how I will do? So we should not do that, we should actually loop through it actually. Okay, how we will loop, just see me. So once you get an item ID, you should check whether it is empty or it is having some data, right? It's a deletion box. Check item. What I will do is, I will just check if the item ID is empty or not empty. Not empty means what? It is having some data, means it is a valid data. So if it is item ID, is this is the expression for checking whether if it is not null or not empty. Okay, so it is like this. If the deletion is yes, means it is not null, not empty. Okay, then what I have to do? I have to link it. So I have to check this. If it is successful, I will remove the breakpoint, go through it. Else what to do? Else I will remove the delete from here, end from here, and then what I will do is I will move the end here. Means if there is item, continue with the processing. If there is no item, or if the item ID is empty, stop it. So after mark status, what you have to go? So it's a loop you have to create manually. So I think you remember the circular path. So circular path we have seen in our initial videos, where we create a loop on our own, right? So this is some that kind of logic, right? So once we started, get the next item, do the processing. Once it is successful, get the next item and do the processing like this. So the process will go on until all the items are completed, right? Let's do it. I did not save. And then let me run it. So item ID, get the item ID. Check if male or female. See, Mr. Name 3 came. Now it's going to the next item. If you see here, it is looping. It will be very fast if you keep in fast mode. Name 4 also Mr. So name 5 is also Mr. I think name 6 is Miss, it should come. So go to see if the advent, Miss name 6, and then it coming, now it is retrieving, it will not have data, and then it should go to end. If you see here, item ID is empty and the process stopped. So let us refresh and go back to our control room and then do a refresh. If you see here, all the things except one is processed successfully, and then if you see here, this is the steps, means this is the report. 5 are worked, this is how it is there. Cool, right? It's very easy, and then there will be no problem for us, right? So this is how it happens, right? So we have successfully processed. So hope you have understood how to do this, right? Keep watching our videos, keep learning.